You are now tuned in to I Am Encouraged Radio.
We travel around the world, you know. I've been traveling around the world now for a good 8 years, Pastor Anna. And in my traveling, you know, I learned that you can't just be one-dimensional. You can't just go overseas with an American mentality. Think that everybody's going, you know, bow to our American way and culture. I don't hear you here. You know, when you go overseas and go to a place like Japan, where only 1% of the population is Christian, you've got to learn how to worship God like the Japanese do. You don't just go over there and say, you know, as the deer panteth for the water, so my soul longeth after thee. You alone are my heart's desire, and I long to worship thee. Oh, you alone are my strength and my shield. To you alone doth my spirit yield. Hallelujah. You alone are my heart's desire, and I long to worship thee. But in Japan, you've got to sing so the Japanese can understand. You have to become all things to all men that you might save some. So in Japan, you've got to say, Tanigawa yo nakari ashita ushika no yoni Shuyo wa ganata nashia anata hoshita u Anata kosu wa gatete Anata koso waga chikara. Hallelujah. That's the same in every language. Anata koso waga nozo miware wa chiyoku. When you go to places like Holland, in the country of Holland, there are cities like Amsterdam, The Hague, Rotterdam, and they all speak Dutch there, so you can't just go there and sing, great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness, morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, dear Lord, unto me. But you've got to sing it in Dutch, and in Dutch it goes like this. When you go to places like South Africa, you got to sing something that the Zulus understand. So you sing, Ngose sikelele Africa, malupakanisu pundalwayo, iswaimitandazo yetu, Ngose sikelele tinalusapalwayo. And all the Zulu women say, whoa, Samoya. You're lying, ain't none of y'all Zulu in this room. Ain't none of y'all Zulu. Then you go down to a little country in South America, on the tip of South America, right next to Curacao, there's a little country called Suriname. And most of you, see, that's why nobody said anything about that, because you've never heard of that place. You're like, Sur who? Suriname. And there they speak a language called Surinamese. I'm still getting a zero here. No, it's not registering. And when you go down to Suriname, you know, there's a song that I sing, and it just simply goes, God of Day Wambungado! And they scream like we've just said something great, and y'all sitting there saying, what? We're gonna try it again. God of Day Wambungado. God of Day Wambungado. One, two, three, four. Oh, 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 aren't dancing, it's because you don't know what in the name of God I just said. Well, let me bring it to your culture in America so you can understand. God is a good God.
Yes, he is.
God is a good God.
Yes, he is.
God is a good God.
Yes, he is.
God is a mighty, mighty good God.
Yes, he is.
1, 2, 3, 4.
You pick me up.
You turn me around.
You turn me around.
Place my feet on.
Place my feet on.
High around.
High around.
You pick me up.
You pick me up.
You turn me around.
You turn me around.
Place my feet. And when you go down to the Hispanic countries, do I have any Hispanic people here? Any Latinos here? There's a song they taught me, says, yo tengo un gozo en mi alma, gozo en mi alma, gozo en mi alma, y mi ser, como ríos de agua viva, ríos de agua viva, ríos de agua viva, y mi ser, say,
yo tengo un gozo en mi alma,
come on, go.
Yes, friends, today on I Am Encouraged Radio, today's show is called Bridge the Gap, because that's exactly what we want to do. You know, our message for today is going to come from 1 Corinthians chapter 9, and we're going to start at verse 19. But friends, you know, they're growing up. You know, as a young man, when I was in church with my best friend, we started a gospel rap group called the Holy Hot Boys because we were bored in church. And our pastor, my best friend's dad, embraced it and allowed us to go forth and minister through gospel rap. And we were able to do something quite frequently. And we made CDs and traveled and did all kinds of stuff. Simply because he knew that if he wanted to reach the young people, he had to give them a voice. And now we're all grown up, but friends, we still have bridges that we need to gap. Because what I understand and what I've come to realize, friends, is that we all have some sort of barrier. And the thing that I really like about I Am Encouraged Radio is that our audience is so diverse. We have some people who are Hispanic who listen to the show. They may be half black and Hispanic. We have some Anglo white people who listen to the show. Some black people who listen to the show. And today, friends, we're going to celebrate whatever race we are, whatever it is that you like to listen to within the gospel genre. We want to celebrate it today. And friends, I'm not going to go all the way out. I'm not going to play a whole bunch of different things, but I want to play a few things just to kind of bridge the gap. And so I'm going to start it off. We already had Donnie McClurkin kind of introduce us to it today. But what I want to do is I want to play something by the Holy Hot Boys. That's the group that I was just telling you about that my best friend and some of our other friends started way back in 1999. And so here's a song that we released not too long ago called Hype Enough. And what it's simply saying is, I know that the world is hype. I know that they have their little crunk parties and all the stuff that they're doing, but they're not hype enough for the praise and the level of excitement that we have about our God. Their hypeness cannot beat the hypeness that we have for our God, because we're hyper than hype. Take a listen, friends.
Yeah.
Yes, friends, that was Toby Mac with Catch a Fire, Whoopsie Daisy. And that was a mixture of reggaeton and just a couple of different things. And so, friends, whatever it is that you want to do, however it is you want to worship your God, it is out there for you. There is gospel reggaeton out there, and I have several different artists and everything that I could recommend to you. Just feel free to email me and ask me any of those questions at 21daysofencouragement@gmail.com, or you can always, always leave a comment here on the Spreaker page as you're listening to the radio show. And I look at each and every one of those and will respond to it. So friends, whatever it is you're looking for, and maybe you may be looking for more stuff, I have plenty of different things that I would love to share with you. But let's get back to the music. And here's Israel Houghton with Surely Goodness. It's a little bit of reggae for you.
Jamaica! Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me, follow me all my days. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me, yeah, follow me all of the days of my life. Oh, 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 oh.
Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me, follow me all my days. Surely goodness and mercy shall Can I get up now? Be still and know I am God. Uh-huh.
I've been trying to do it on my own.
Yes, Lord.
But right now I gotta surrender. You know what's best.
Say it like you mean it.
It's not easy waiting on you. It's not easy believing that you got this together. But without faith, it's impossible to please you.
I recognize you.
So I'ma stand right here.
We are still before
you. You got me.
Still before you.
You got me. You got me.
Chasing after you. Oh, I know rules have much to bring. My heart's torn to pieces. It's my offering.
Friends, we need to take each other to the King. We have to bridge the gap. Friends, there's so many of your friends, there's so many of your peers, those people who you talk to on a daily basis, who you hang out with, who may just want a closer walk with God, but they feel as though in order to have a closer walk with Him, that they have to change everything, the music that they listen to, the type of music, they have to stop enjoying movies and all these different things. But friends, what I want you to know, and what I want you to understand, is that God is available to you however you are ready to receive Him. And friends, I want to prove that through Scripture. 1 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 19 starts off saying this: though I am free and belong to no one, this is the New International Version, I have made myself a slave to everyone to win as many as possible. To the Jews, I became like a Jew to win the Jews. To those under the law, I became like one under the law, though I myself am not under the law, so as to win those under the law. To those not having the law, I became like one not having the law, though I am not free from God's law, but am under Christ's law, so as to win those not having the law. To the weak, I became weak to win the weak. I have become all things to all people, so that by all possible means I might save some. I do all of this for the sake of the gospel, that I may share in its blessings. Friends, I really want you to know that you don't have to change who you are. You don't have to stop enjoying the type of music that you love, the movies that you love, simply because you are a Christian. I'm not saying, friends, that you don't need to stop listening to rap music with all the cursing and all of that. Put that aside, but there is still good rap music out there. There's gospel rap that's out there. I'm not saying don't listen to the rock music, because there's still good Christian rock. And it goes just as hard, or even harder, as the stuff that you may already be listening to. I'm not saying don't enjoy movies. What I'm saying, friends, is that you have to be careful of the type of movies you watch. You have to guard your ear gates, your eye gates, because these are all things, passageways for the enemy to come in and attack your life. So if you're watching horror flicks all the time and then you wonder why you're having nightmares, friends, enjoy movies, but just be careful of what you partake of. That's simply what I want to encourage you in today, is friends, enjoy the things that you've always enjoyed, but just be mindful that there is a better way. There are always good Christian wholesome movies. There may be movies that may not have Christ or the cross in them at all, but they're still good movies that you can watch and not have to worry about how is this tainting my spirit. Friends, I want to encourage you, step out of your comfort zone. Step out of what's comfortable to you and begin to bridge the gap for someone else who may be wondering, I would like to be saved, but I'm not ready to give up everything. Show them that they don't have to give it up, but they can just critique it and change it just a little bit, and it still give God glory. Friends, I've shared some of everything from reggaeton to reggae to gospel rap, all of it today, simply to encourage you that God is available for you however it is you need Him, however it is you may want Him. And I want to leave you with this last song by Marvin Sapp called Comfort Zone. Take a listen, friends, and let's step out of our comfort zone and begin to bridge the gap. Even if you don't like a certain music, maybe your child likes it. Get into that style of music so that you can help bring your child into the body of Christ and they can have something to cling on to. Friends, I'm telling you, when I was a young boy and my best friend and I started the gospel rap group, the Holy Hot Boys, it was our bridge into the church. It made church real to us, and we began to minister to other young people. And because of this, we were able to rap and open up for people like Adina Howard, Choppa, Master P, all of these people, simply because someone said, I need to bridge the gap with my young people. I need to let them have their own way to express what they feel and how they love God. So let me encourage you, friends, step out of your comfort zone and bridge the gap.
I'm coming out of my comfort zone. Some of the places in my life that's comfortable, God is challenging me. Trust and believe, for to go where I've not gone, I must do what I've not done. So I'm coming out of my comfort zone. Though it may cost me some friends, I'll walk alone. God is challenging me to trust and believe, for to go where I've not gone, I must do what I've not done.
God is wrong
to walk into my destiny.
God is challenging me
to go where I've not been.
God is moving,
and for the rest of my life, I'll say yes,
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 yes.
I'm coming out of my
zone. Won't I be stretched to a place where I've never known? God is challenging me,
so trust and be free, for to go where I'm not going, I must do what I've not done. No,
God is calling
to walk into my destiny.
God is challenging me
to go where I've not been.
God is moving,
and for the rest of my
yes,
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 I'm coming out out of my comfort zone. I'm being stretched to a place I never know. God is challenging me. Trust and believe. If you're coming out, lift your hands and give him praise right now. I said, if you're coming out, lift those hands and bless the name of the Lord. Come on, help me praise him right now. He's worthy to be glorified. Come on, come on, help me worship him right now. Coming out. Things that held me bound. Things that had me locked down.
We love you, friends. And we want to see you bridge the gap. I Am Encouraged Radio is a licensed affiliate of Encouragement Ministries. You be blessed, friend, and we'll see you again soon.